The voice isolation feature in Final Cut Pro is absolutely awesome, but if you're feeling a little bit isolated about how to use it, this video will explain what it is, how to use it, also a giant problem that it has, and a simple way to fix that problem. So believe it or not, what the voice isolation feature in Final Cut Pro does is it isolates voices. But what that really means is that it functions more like a de-reverb effect. Now you might know or use terms like reverb and echo when you're talking to audio, and they're very, very similar, but they are a bit different. Echo is like if you go to the Grand Canyon and you go echo, 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 and you hear it repeat over and over again because there's a longer amount of time between those sound waves bouncing off of something and bouncing back. Reverb is sort of the opposite. There's less time between sound waves bouncing off of something and bouncing back. So the effect of that is that the person listening to that audio then becomes aware of the space that the audio is recorded in. Sometimes that can be super cool, like for instruments and music, having reverb can really make things sound amazing. But when it comes to something like this, recording voice for video, reverb can absolutely be a problem because, for example, right now I'm in this room, it has walls, a ceiling, as most rooms do. I also have this hard surface of a desk. I have a computer monitor over there. Those are all flat, hard surfaces that sound waves bounce off of and come back. And while the best way to handle that is to really treat and adapt to the space that you're in by using things like acoustic panels or sound blankets, positioning your microphone in the best possible location, sometimes it's not always practical and it can be expensive, and sometimes it's not even possible depending on your filming situation. So that's where voice isolation can really come in and save the day. Now, as great as it is, it's not absolute magic and you can push it too far, but what it tries to do is get rid of all of those reflections, all of that reverb, and just focus on the voice in an audio clip. So for example, right now the audio you're listening to is just straight out of the camera. It's not processed at all. I am using a really nice microphone, so the quality should be pretty decent and the microphone's not too far away from me, but you can probably still hear a little bit of the space that I'm in. But if I turn on the voice isolation feature just a little bit, now you can hear it really brings out my voice a little bit more and de-emphasizes all of that room tone, all those reverb reflections, and all that kind of stuff. So to use voice isolation, you just select the audio clip or the video clip with the audio that you want to use. You go over to your audio tab and then you click on voice isolation. By default, it will start at 50%, and I think that is way too much. The goal with these kinds of effects is to be very, very subtle. You don't want to draw attention to the fact that you're using them. So I usually start somewhere more around 15%, and I try not to go past 25% if possible. It could take it too far. So right now, I'm only using a little bit of voice isolation on the audio you're hearing. But if I take that all the way up to 100%, it's going to start sounding a little bit funky and a little bit like garbly and wavy, and it's kind of distracting to listen to. But if I back that back down to a reasonable level, now it sounds really, really good. Much better than this, which is the unprocessed audio just coming straight out of the camera. Now here's another example. This camera over here is pretty far away from me, probably over 6 feet, about 2 meters away from me, and it has a microphone just on the camera, which is in an absolutely terrible position. And this is what that audio sounds like. You can really hear the room in this. It does not sound isolated at all. But if I turn on voice isolation just a little bit, you can hear that it does make a little bit of a difference. And if I crank it all the way to 100, it's still not gonna sound absolutely amazing. So it's not like a magic bullet that means you'd never have to focus on good audio. Even when you're using voice isolation, your ultimate goal should be to record good audio into your camera or into your audio recorder while you're filming. And then after that is when you can use your editing software to make it sound its absolute best. But that's really all there is to it when it comes to using voice isolation. You just select your clip, turn on voice isolation, and then select the amount you want to use, keeping a light touch to help things sound natural and their best. But here is where there is a giant problem that I've encountered with voice isolation. I'll show you an example. This video right here is my recent video about the M1 Mac Mini. And for this video, I did what I normally do, which is I have a talking headshot that has my main audio. I put that in my timeline and then I start cutting it up, getting rid of all the mistakes and all of the unnecessary stuff. But whenever you're cutting up a clip like this, unless you're able to cut in a spot of complete silence, there's probably going to be a little bit of a pop of audio that makes it very obvious there was a cut. So for example, if I just put a cut in the middle of this sentence right here and I play it, not a video editor yourself, I am cutting the middle of a word, but if you hear there's like an actual crack, a snap, crackle, or a pop, some kind of Rice Krispie is taking place in the midst of this clip. If you're not a video editor yourself or a media, and that's a very normal thing that happens, and an easy way to take care of that is just to add a small fade on the audio track. You can just grab this little thing right here and drag it over just a little bit, and then that should eliminate it. A video editor yourself or a Again, I'm in the middle of a word, so the context doesn't make any sense, but there's no more pop on this cut right here. If you're not a video editor yourself or a media, when you do those little fades, you wanna be sure that you're not fading too much, because if you fade out a lot, and even if you're not a video editor yourself, it sounds very unnatural and almost sounds like you're starting to run out of breath while you're talking, and then you come back really loud and it just becomes really distracting for the person who's listening to that video. So you probably don't wanna do that. Now, what I've been doing up until now is basically just editing like I always do, which is I'll just put a raw clip in the timeline, and before I edit it, that's when I add all my color correction, and then I also adjust my audio. So that's where I will adjust the level to make sure it's where I want it to be. If I'm going to add any kind of equalization or something, that's where I'll add that. And this is also where I've been adding the voice isolation. So here's this clip right here with no voice isolation. Because something new comes out doesn't mean this is any less capable than it was before. It doesn't sound bad because the mic is positioned well, but if I turn on voice isolation, turn it back down to, you know, 20%, and then also you can just play your audio back and turn it on and off to hear the effect, I mean this is any less capable than it was before. It doesn't suddenly become a less powerful computer, or it's not gonna suddenly not work as well with your workflow. So especially now when there are no other options in terms. So I've been adding all of that to my clip, and then I start editing it like normal. But here's where I start having a problem, is when I'm cutting between stuff, I'll still have those pops like normal with a future model. That's obvious. I can just try to fix them like normal by adding in my little fades. People can maintain this price point with a future model. That's obvious. But the problem I'm encountering with voice isolation is that even when I add my little fades like normal, price point with a future model, that's obvious. Sometimes there are still those pops, and it's kind of inconsistent. If I play that same clip over a bunch of times, sometimes it will have the pop and sometimes it will not have the pop, and I can't figure out what the difference is. Same goes when exporting. It's kind of a coin toss if when it's exported there's going to be a pop or there's not. So my brain is about to pop because it's incredibly frustrating, and it's gotten to the point where I've started using longer fades to try and like counteract that effect. Maintain this price point with a future model, that's obvious. But even with a longer fade like right here, there's still a pop. Future model, that's obvious. So here's the easiest way to fix that issue. All you need to do is add your audio and your video clips with your audio to your timeline like normal. You can adjust the levels like you normally would. You can add other equalization that you normally would. Everything that you normally would, except for voice isolation. Do not add voice isolation at this point. Just make it sound good otherwise. Then go through and edit it, cut it up like normal. You can add your fades, you can even overlap audio, which, by the way, if you didn't know this, this is very, very cool. If you have separate audio, like this clip right here, I have the clip and the audio and they're separate. I can sometimes overlap the audio to make it sound a little more natural, and you can just use the period and the comma keys to nudge things over one frame at a time. So if I select the edge of this video clip, I can nudge it over one or two frames, and then you can do J cuts and L cuts, which I'm not JKing about, those are pretty awesome. But another cool thing you can do is if you don't have your audio detached on a clip, you can just double click on the audio and then it will show you the separate audio and video, and then you can do the same thing. You can click on the video and use period and comma keys to nudge things over one frame at a time, either the video or the audio, and then you can double click when you're done and it puts it back. So you didn't actually detach the audio, but it's a quick way to do that kind of editing on any clip. But for this solution to this problem, you're going to need to detach audio. So I hope you're not too attached to your audio, because you're gonna need to detach from it. So in this example right here, I've got my video all edited, but I don't have any voice isolation applied. I have some clips that are separate. I have music, I have a couple sound effects in here. And what I need to do first is detach all of my clips. So the easiest way to do that is to just select all of my video clips, right click, and then click on detach audio. And that is going to bring down the audio separately from every clip. Now the next thing I need to do is select only the clips that I want to add isolation to, which in this case is all of the dialogue. If they're not already selected, an easy way to do it is to just hold down the command key and then you can click on different clips, or you can click and drag to select all your different audio clips. In my case, it's most of them. Just be sure that you're not selecting any music or sound effects or anything that you don't want voice isolation applied to. And if you're working with clips from two different locations, I would do this separately for each location. So if I had a bunch of audio from this room, I would do this separately. And if I had a bunch of audio from, you know, somewhere else, then I would isolate that separately. Once I have everything selected, I can just right click on any of those clips and then select new compound clip. I could also press Alt G and that will give me the same menu. And now I can merge all of those clips into one audio clip. If you've never worked with compound clips, I can compound your interest in them by letting you know that if you double click on it, you can still go in and see all of your edits and all of your individual clips. And then you can just click this little arrow here to go back out of your compound clip. On your main timeline, it's just going to show up as one clip. And then this is the clip that you can select and add voice isolation to. And now it will apply it to all of these very evenly, and it should look and sound great. Or it should sound great. The audio is not going to look great. And it's not going to affect any of your fades or your cuts. You're not going to bring back any of those snaps, crackles, or pops into your video, which is really going to make your audio pop in the good way. So this is really the last step before exporting. Once you've got everything edited, that's when you can compound all of your audio clips together and then add voice isolation to that specific clip right there. And then export and you're all done. I'm pretty sure that this issue of the voice isolation causing unwanted pops and things is just a bug on how the effect is working when it's turning on and off between like clips that are side by side. And so hopefully there will be an update to Final Cut Pro in the future that addresses this and takes care of that problem. But in the meantime, this is a very quick and easy way to solve that problem. So then you can still use voice isolation on all of your audio tracks to make them sound their absolute best. And speaking of things I don't want to isolate, thank you to everyone who helps support my channel through Patreon and YouTube channel memberships. And if you want a few more tips and tricks to help you become the Final Cut Pro, check out these videos right here.